Hello, guys. Welcome back to Maths on African Motives. We are still on our Euclidean geometry, working with past exam papers. Now we are working with question papers as we are done with the introduction and the theorems that are required. So this is another question that you're going to work on question number six. We are given 6.1 to prove that the opposite sides in a parallelogram A, B, C, D are equal. The opposite sides are equal. All right. This is what you're going to need as long as you're to prove that these opposite sides are equal. You either work with one of the diagonals. I explained this on those introductions. So we're going to see. Okay, then there's another question that you're going to see also. So it's a total of 13. I just hope we're going to learn a lot from these questions. Anyways, let me just try to reduce a little bit. I just want us to have this whole space to see exactly from the diagram. So I'm just gonna, all right, do like this. Okay, so this is it, guys. We talked about this actually, that what you need is to have one of the diagonals that you can work with. All right, so in this case, I'm going to work with the diagonal AC. I'm going to join AC. So it's either you join one of the diagonals, all right? So join the diagonal AC, right? The diagonal AC. So you're gonna choose one of the diagonals. Either you're gonna work with BD or you're gonna work with AC. So as for me, I'm going to work with AC like this. All right, let me just join this way. All right, something like this. So after joining AC, this diagonal, I want you to see something that is happening here. We are creating angles on these two triangles. We are creating angles there that are the same. Considering the parallel lines, because we can see that AB is parallel to DC. So from that concept, it follows that the angle A here is the same as this angle at C. So in order for us to name these properly, we can just mention this one and this two, this one and this also two. So what I'm simply saying, the angle A1, this one, and the angle C2, they are equal. We are creating a Z. This is a Z, alternate angles, right? Remember the concept of your Z angles. Either like this, these angles are equal. These angles are equal. So that is the concept that you're applying. So it follows that the angle A1 will be equal to angle C2. These two angles are equal, alternate angles. We're talking about alternate angles. So I'm just going to write in short, alternate angles like this in short. From which concept? From AB parallel to DC or CD, right? Since here, since AB is parallel to DC or CD. Okay. Remember, we want to prove the sides. So what I want us to have is to figure out the congruent figures, because we know that if figures are congruent, guys, the sides will be equal, the angles will be equal, everything will be equal. So we want to figure out those congruent figures. Is it possible? Yes, it's very possible. Okay, we talked about A1. What about A2? The angle A2 on this side, this one, you see that it is going to be equal to C1. We are creating a Z from the parallel line AD and CB. These two, they are parallel. So we are creating a Z again. If you check properly here, we are creating a Z. So this angle A2 and this angle C1, they will be equal. We have a Z like this. Okay, that's N. So meaning to say here, we're going to say angle A2 is equal to angle C1. All right. The concept again is also of the alternate angles, but this time it's not from AB and DC being parallel. It's from these two sides which are parallel, AD and CB. So this is from AD being parallel to CB or BC. Okay? So considering that these two angles are equal, these two angles are equal, and here we've got a common side. Here we've got a common side, which is AC, because we considered AC. We have got congruent figures there. We've got a common side, right? AC there. A common side AC. Let me write common side AC. All right. So if we have this, therefore we are saying these two figures, they are congruent. If these two figures are congruent, what does it mean? If these two figures are congruent, what does it mean? It means that we're going to take this way. All right, so we have got this condition because we've got this side that we have. Remember what from this part here. We have got this common side. So this common side, which is AC, this angle and this angle, this angle and this angle. So you can consider this as the side angle angle, or we can consider this as the angle side angle. All right, let me write this way. If we take it from A to C to D, we're going to take it as A to C to B. If we take it as A, D, C, the direction is important. If you take it as A, D, C, you are going to take it in the form of the angle A, this one, being equal to angle C1. So it's going to be C, B, D. If you take it as C, D, B, you have to consider the angle C2, this one. C2, remember, is equal to A1. So it is going to be congruent to triangle A, B, C. So the way that you take your triangle is very, very important. So in this case, we are saying triangle A, D, C. All right? It's going to be congruent to. So remember, this A2 is the one that we are referring to as the angle C. So we're going to start from C. So it is going to be from C to B to A. Remember, A1 is equal to, this A1 here is equal to C2. A1 and C2 are equal. So at the end, this must be A, like this. So these are your congruent figures. So it follows that if these are congruent figures, the sides must be equal. AD, this side, must be equal to CB. Automatically, AD is equal to CB. Also, it follows that DC, this part of DC, is equal to, you take from B to A. So it also follows that DC is equal to BA. So if it is the case, let us check. AD equal to CB. AD, this is our AD, this one. Equal to CB, this is our CB. So as you can see, these are opposite sides. They are equal. DC, BA, DC, BA, DC, BA, these are opposite sides. And we are seeing that these are opposite. So meaning to say, we have proved that the opposite sides in a parallelogram are equal. This is what we can see here. This is exactly what we have. So that is opposite sides of a parallelogram. Of a parallelogram are equal. Right? So that's it. Equal. So we could have the case of the writing of congruent figures might be different, but if truly you are having the same or the exact congruent figures, you are going to obtain the same sides or the same answers. So I want you to try with whatever way that you are seeing or that you can work with, and you see that you're going to have the same answers. If you take up your sides at the end, you will see that is the same. Prove on 6.21, we ask you to prove. All right. Prove that angle E1 is equal to F2 from this parallelogram you're given in fig AE, that is from A. Okay, let's figure out from A to E to C to F. This is a parallelogram. So we're given that this is a parallelogram. All right. So if this be a parallelogram, AECF, it means the side AF is equal to the side EC. The side AE, which is parallel to CF, they are also equal. And remember, the diagonals here, they bisect each other. So in terms of the diagonals, it means from E to O, it is the same as from O to F. Also, from O to A, it is the same as from O to C, right? And also about the angles, you know that the angle at A is equal to the angle at C. The whole of the angle at E is equal to the whole of the angle at F. Opposite angles are equal on a parallelogram. These are the properties that we know. Okay, so let's see. And also a given AD is parallel to DC, AD is parallel to BC. All right, which is fine. This one and this one, they're parallel. Okay, now let's see. The first question was that prove that angle E1 is equal to F2. All right, where is E1? All right, that's 6.21. Let us just write it aside, 6.21. So we want to prove that the angle E1 is equal to F2. Prove that. Angle E1 is equal to F2. So how can we prove this? Okay, this is where we have our angle E1. This is our E, and E1 is this angle here. Right, this is our angle E1. F2, this is our F. We've got F1 and F2. This is our F2 here. Okay, this is what we have. Okay, so I want us to see something here. If we are to consider this, the angle F1, this angle at F1, and the angle at E, because we just want to be closer to E, from the parallel lines, all right? From the parallel line concept, this angle at E, at F1, this one, and this angle at E2, there's something common there. They're equal, right? If you consider properly, we've got the parallel lines, AF being parallel to EC. So there we are creating a Z from A to F, all right? We go to E to C like this, right? We are creating a Z, as you can see. So these two angles are equal alternate angles. So that means the angle at F1, all right? Let's just write down. The angle F1 is equal to the angle at E2, all right? There we are talking about alternate angles. Alternate angles from which side that are parallel, AF and EC being parallel. All right, we have got AF parallel to EC. Okay, which is fine. So this angle is equal to this angle. Okay, so we want to prove that these two, they are equal. Okay, we want to prove that this one and this one are equal. All right. So it follows that angle F2, this F2 here, F2, written in terms of F1. Remember, they are on a straight line, all right? F2 and F1. So let us just write this way. F1 plus F2, angle F1 plus angle F2 is equal to 180 degrees. We are talking about what? Angles on a straight line. On a straight line. All right, which is fine. So why am I talking about this? I want you to see something. If these two angles are equal, let us find it, because what you want to prove is to prove E1 and F2. So let's find F2 in terms of what? In terms of F1. So F2, angle F2 is equal to, we just transpose F1 to the other side, it gives us minus. So this is going to be 180 degrees minus angle F1. All right. But remember that here we are saying F1 is equal to E2. Remember that. Remember this. All right, let's leave it like that. This is our F2. We are going to find E1 because we want to see that E1 and F2, they are equal. This is what we want to see. So let's find E1. All right, again, E1 and E2, just like F1 and F2, they are on a straight line. So it follows that if I add the angle E1 plus the angle E2, I'm supposed to get 180 degrees. We are still having the same concept, angles on a straight line. All right, angles on a straight line. Angles on a straight line. All right, which is fine. So let's find E1 because we want, guys, we are not supposed to find E2 because we want to prove that E1 is equal to F2. So just like we wrote F2 in terms of F, let us do the same thing for what we want, sorry, which is E2, which is E1, I mean. So we are going to find E1. So E1 is going to be equal to what? We transpose E2 to the other side. It becomes a negative since it is a positive here. So it is going to be 180 degrees minus E2, like this. All right. So if you check this angle and this angle, they are equal, but they're written different. How so? Because we said angle F1 is equal to angle E2. We prove, we talked about this from the alternate angles. F1 is equal to E2. So that means in place of E2, I can even write this as angle E1 is equal to 180 degrees minus. In place of this angle E2, I can write it as F1. Just like here, I wrote in terms of F1, so I can write it in terms of F1 like this. So as we can see, these two angles are exactly the same. We wrote them from different ways, but they are giving us the same answer. So that is E1 is equal to F2. This is what we wanted to prove. E1 is equal to F2. So that is exactly what we have. So therefore, E1 is equal to F2, which is equal to 180 degrees minus F1 or whatever that you want. Or you can even write it in terms of X if you want. You can even write it in terms of X. Or just to prove this way, again, because we know that this way, this angle and this angle are equal. Just for us to say these two angles, they give us 180 degrees. It definitely tells us that F2 and E2 there and E1, they're exactly the same. There's no other way. They will be the same. All right. But in actual case of understanding, this can help you in terms of your understanding so that you can also figure out exactly what you're talking about. Are they really equal in terms of this understanding? I think it can be much better for you. 6.22, ABCD is a parallelogram. We want to prove now that ABCD, the whole of this shape, ABCD is a parallelogram. All right. The first thing that we have is that these two sides are parallel. So the guarantee of us having a parallelogram is there. We have that guarantee of having a parallelogram. All right. Then let us check something. We're just going to try to do it stage by stage. All right. Remember, for a parallelogram, we can prove from the sides. Remember the properties of a parallelogram. Just like this part, we saw that the opposite sides are parallel and the opposite sides are parallel and equal. Then the opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. These are the properties of a parallelogram. So we want to see which one can we use to prove that. So it's not like when you ask you to prove, you've got a certain answer automatically. No, it's not like that. All right. But I want us to see from the concept of the parallel lines, because we are given that this is parallel. So if you are to consider that we are going to use the same condition, just you can use the same condition as this one, but it's going to be a repetition if we use that. All right. So I want to avoid using this repetition of this of this part that we proved here. All right. So what can we do? I want you to see properly. AD is parallel to BC. And from there, it can give us the angles that are the same. All right, if we take it like this, all right, if we take it like this, I just want you to see this, because this proof part, most of us guys, we've got a misunderstanding. So I'm just trying to make you understand. I don't know if you're gonna be able to understand this. Okay, so this is what you're gonna do. You have already told that these two, they are parallel, right? We are not told that they're equal, we just know that they're parallel. So from that concept, you see that from this diagonal, BD, there's a diagonal there, BD. From this diagonal, BD, all right. The angle, this D1, which is the angle that we are seeing here, and this angle will be equal. Alternate angles we are creating a Z, right? So if you consider that, we are creating a Z. So this angle and this angle are equal alternate angles. So meaning to say here, we've got an angle that is the same, the angle at D1, this angle here at D1, and the angle at B, which is this one at B2, they're equal. All right. Let's consider that. I'm just going to write it aside. All right, let me just write aside here. So I said angle D1. All right, so this is 6.22. Angle D1 is equal to angle B2. So you'll be asking, why am I talking about this? You understand me very soon. Okay, these are alternate angles. Alternate angles, we talked about this. They create what? They create a Z, alternate angles from AD being parallel to BC, AD and BC being parallel. All right. This is what we have. We are given before from a parallelogram. All right. So it means this side AF and the side EC, they are equal from A to F and from E to C. These two sides are equal. All right. Why am I talking about this? Remember, what we want is for us to prove in terms of sides. So if we can have sides which are, if we can just have sides which are equal, if we can see that this side and this side are equal, we are done. So for now, what we can just prove, or what we can just at least work on, is to prove that side AD is equal to BC. If we can prove, because already they are parallel. So if we can prove that, therefore, we are done. We cannot have one pair of opposite sides being parallel and equal. It cannot be like that. Already it's parallel. So let's see if it can be equal. So by finding this angle D1 and this angle here, you will see that already, because remember we proved before that E1, this angle here, and this F2 are equal. We proved that. All right. So from this side, F2, angle F2 is equal to E1. We proved this. All right. Then the last thing that you're going to see is that the side AF, this side, and this side EC, this side here, this side and this side here, that I'm indicating here, and this side, they are equal. Remember, we are told this one is a parallelogram. We told it about this before. So it means the side of AF is equal to the side of EC from the what? Opposite sides of a parallelogram. So these are just opposite sides of a parallelogram. So I'm just going to write in short of a parallelogram, which is A, that is parallelogram AECF, the one that we're given before here. All right, we told about this. So these two sides, they're equal. So meaning to say, we've got a case of congruency that can have, that we can have, considering that we have got angle D1, angle F2, and the side. We've got the same thing, the angle D1, which is the angle B2, the angle F2, which is the angle E1, and the side EC, which are equal. These two triangles, they are congruent. So you can consider the triangle from A to F to D, triangle AFD being congruent to, if we take AFD, take note, from A to F, we are talking about side AF, meaning to say we are talking about this side of EC. But take note, we are going to the angle at F, which is the angle at E1. So we are supposed to start from C going to E. All right? So this will be C, that will be triangle C to E. Then the last part is the ending point. So we say this is going to be CE. The last part, which is the ending point at D, the angle at D, which is this D1, is the same as the angle at B. So this, the ending point is going to be B. So take note how you take your figures, which are congruent. Take note. So that'll be side, angle, this one. All right? So from this concept, what we just want to prove is to say that these two must be equal, because already we are told that they are parallel. So is it the case? Let's check where there is AD and where there is BC. We are going to see that AD here and CB here, if we take it that way, A to D, C to B. So it means AD is equal to CB from the congruent figure. Just like if we want to take AF, it means AF is equal to CB, to CE, right? If we take FD, FD is equal to EB. That is the case. From F to D and from E to B, they will be equal. So that is the case. But as we want to focus on AD and BC, because already this is the side of the parallelogram. These are the sides of the parallelogram that we have. And from the sides of the parallelogram that we have, this is the condition that we are given, that it's already parallel. This side and this side, we are already told that they are parallel. So by having AD being equal to CB, it's a default thing, it's a definite thing that this is a parallelogram. The reason being that we are having one pair of opposite sides equal, at the same time, parallel. So remember the properties of a parallelogram, all right? So therefore, ABCD is a parallelogram. All right, so the reason there, we are having one pair of opposite sides equal and parallel. So you're going to just write equal and parallel. So this is the condition that you are working with. So once they are equal and parallel, there is no way it's going to be a parallelogram. If there was an opportunity for us to prove using the angles, we're going to do that, but it's difficult on this question because we are not given any hint or any angle that we can work with or that we can work from. So we used the information that we have. So that was the best information for us to use in this case, to work from the congruent figures to prove that these two sides that already there are parallel, if we can just prove them that they are also equal, therefore it is a what? It is a parallelogram. So that is the case of the proof. So we shall see, guys, working with more questions, but I just hope you understand the basics of the questions that you're given on the proof.